Hi.
Chicken leg.
Chick. Poison-tipped harpoon, commanding a convoy ship of the noisiest baboons with cannibalistic cowboy hips, chewing wads of cancer, spitting nicotine nectar, moon top dancers, mystery messengers, infinity gem collectors, and kryptonite containment units with symphony receptors, synthesize a faint acoustic, sharing a hookah with a musical fairy, jamming my tooth into the fruit of her berry. Vinci, convince me, Mona is not Lewinsky, sick of the whiskey, get a soda, come on, sit with me for a moment, can you interest me, enroll one that's too big for me, she said, Romeo, pick these, they grow in a risk any, go from mistress to queen, go from oceans, rivers to streams, go in between and flow into a dream, I notice things like sometimes it's the hole that's clean, with broken wings, teeth clenched to her rosary beads, maybe if I wait long enough she'll come knocking on my door, maybe I'll fall in love as I'm walking to the store, maybe if I clean my act up she'll recognize it instantly, maybe this little seed I plant will never die within me, maybe if I would have treated her better she wouldn't have needed better, if we were forever you wouldn't be reading this letter. And if I sleep with Heather, would she ever forgive me? If I keep it together, would she never forget me? In her eyes, I seen her soul as I quietly folded. Now I'm mining for gold as she said, buy me a soda. She's as high as it goes. I'm the horizon controller, divine as a rose, rising like a cobra.
Oh, you want that on? All right. Yeah, girl, sing it. Snow is like a whiteout blanket and clever adjective, blowing the lights out of the candle that never matches lit. I practice the priesthood of balancing the elements, battling the seasons and the master intelligence. Her veins flow as rivers to the heart of the ocean. Her mane is gold and silver in a harmonic motion. I'm reputed amusingly that Pazuzu is beautiful. Fruitless, foolish me, I tuned with voodoo musicals, assuming my new pseudonym is choosing miracles and executing them. I flew to the moon again, losing spiritual restitution then. Crystallizing to a moment for the hypnotized to discover the synthesized consequence for kryptonite in the bubbler. The winter jungle summons me with 600 hummingbees. It's haunting season. Her lips shudder in the suffering screams or something. Transition of seasons occurs with a calm chaos of absence of senses, sentences, and words found way off. Gradually bending emotions, the departure of lovers naturally made and broken. Then further from the summer, the warmth of affection and the soothing inside from the sworn protection of a groom to a bride. The scornful rejection of beautiful eyes, the mournful reflection of dew in the skies. No one ever said a foolish man once said, a foolish man are often quoted. A body of water is not named so by its frequent inhabitants or for its larger fish, but by its larger inhabitants and for its most frequent fish.
A walking stick has no camouflage, for it is one with nature rather than hide. One confuses its predator by becoming the forest, reaching behind thine enemy and wrapping his gizzard with thorn-patterned vineyard.
A love letter is like a satanic incantation. The desired effect will render her helpless to your will or fuel her hatred. If the spell ricochets, you are helpless to her will, although you hated her all along.
Hate is an emotion of various levels, closest in accordance with love. I drank the potion and buried my shovel in a stone like a sword in the mud. One day, order was restored to the living planet, whose innards were secreted and spewing across the land. Using the waste products of the entity to lay waste its living cells, the virus lay comfortably, but productive and hungry. The sun hung above the treble, humble, and judged, while the blood from the jungle bubbled. He was humming a buzz, and nothing. He was changed as he expanded into the air, creating shades of green in accordance with its contrast layer. The symptoms are contagious in specific ways. We're in the critical stages of a biblical plague. Invisible cage in our individual mazes of cinders and flames from Indian ritual incantations. Interesting games like filling the spaces, or simple and plain like buildings and places. It's a musical play as we interact on stages. It's a beautiful day in my still intact oasis. As honey is being concentrated in front of my curiosity. An organic legion of running machinery, the chloroplast, the queen summoning the seeds, yes, siphoning her from striped yellow black collared workers and ripening their pipes, selling cracking bottle gerbers. The purple pear shaped pen that represented sounds as she spoke in earthly ceremonies, electric in the necklace round her throat, with a ring in her ear to sing and to hear, and a bead in her hair to sink in the air. Now bring me a beer, and I'll drink it with care. The rings on her fingers that twinkle and glare, golden bracelets glowing like smoldering flames from the cobra invasion moment of opening fangs. To measure the beauty of plants contrast to animals is like comparing the vastness of the mountains and seas to the colors of the sky as the sun punches out a clockwork orange violet airbrush. We, the planet, are peasants covered from under the sun. All of creation was designed, assembled, and distributed into a cremation fire to be meddled with and ridiculed by the scholars of the product of his most uncivilized creature. Curiosity may have killed the cat, but George was more equipped to slay the deviant menace with a sword in his orifice, only to find that the key fit perfectly into the demon heart and free its insecurity, uncertainty of the world, and vague of its properties in the thirsty inferno, faking a plague prophecy with a seven severed and neglected ordinary person with misled perceptions stemming from strawberry preservative perversions and stuff.
They once sung festive, they was always sung along. It's recollected in bubbles coming from the sun bomb now.
Claustrophobia.
Hey, 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 hey. Get it, girl. Get it. Squeak it. Squeak, squeak. Squeak it.
trapped under seal for its energy's radiated, burn up fragile crystals and not ventilated. The aroma is a toxic fume. Symptoms may include nausea when concentrated and propelled through plastic balloons into the tubes and canals of a nervous feeling system that twitches rhythmically like certain seizure victims who could never be counter patients. Cancer patient. If the flower was picked before the discovery of nicotine or like an hour since, that still counts too. Thank you. This morning I met a fairy that personified the sunflower just outside my chamber door. What a shame, I thought it, that a fairy should live where she would be doomed to hide into the freest hours of twilight. Nevertheless, I was pleased to see that a woman could actually be as magnificent as a flower, with yellow, golden, silky hair and stamen antenna, the aroma of sweet pollen, standing tall on firm legs that has broken through the granite surface only to be condemned. I'm just gonna go on forever, so I'm gonna press a little red button and chuck this shit down. The most wonderful thing in our summer is the stunning colors that occur. Sun rays through rain falling upwards into autumn so suddenly, then I'm awed by its coming to be. It's an odyssey to see shades of auburn running into green automatically into a nautilusy, magically revolving around anything that offers or agrees. A saucer of tea may spill into a faucet of breeze, or am I still invisible? Lost in a dream from a corner of my oasis rose the top floor of rationalization. I barely notice my privacy invaded while continuing to sneak inhalations from a bundle of quality sage. Its inhabitants and occupation constantly range gradually articulating, ovulated democracies change over exaggerate and constantly maim, backseat navigate, alliance and free game in a taxi and his bladder ache. So my hypothesis is aimed at the factories, magistrates who don't want to be blamed, but will have to at the lavender gates. Corporate spies, they're gonna get theirs once and for all. I was deeply in love with the fairy of the mouth, the Corinthian spring, who pleasured I faithfully with traveling drinks that she could tap at will, like commanding a sink, a rich quenching liquid unlike any other substance, chilled, almost frozen, so the weariest of forger on the dreariest of days could be replenished to fulfillment in the easiest way. Unfortunately, the missing sign reads danger, contaminated water, leads me astray. Creative writing is not work nor play. All chosen carefully for the bouquet presented before the toast. It's evidence of a ghost in endless motion, entering souls with exorcist hosts. Blends of opium melting in molds one day. Plastic wrap citizens from the top floors of buildings will travel to witness the magician who cannot control his killing. The cadillia of a creature worthy of glorious splendor, then crinkle it up and eat its seedless purgatorious center. But if the pen is the wand, grasped by trans-cannibal hands like the feather of a swan, what aspirations could my cerebral actually have? Because talent is imagined in malleable strands. The unbalanced phantasm is from failure to understand. If the sun is a flaming ball of gas sailing above the land, then I'm done complaining. All I ask is make me understand, take me from a man and create me something other than, paint me as a plant, maybe nature's mother can. heart of love, not acrylic, but the passage of the heart. Whose front door is the body, rejecting all passwords until I remembered what God told me in the breath of his last words, that love was an emotion accidentally created, dumped into the potion while he was heavily sedated. In the blueprints of humans, we mentally made it celibately. Relationships were created just to get laid regularly. Quivering breath, my flaming sulfur sword. Thine enemy pleads for mercy, explaining in truth how society created him like a monster. And he knows not what he does, I feel no pity for that, as well as it was instated to the mixing pot of personality. I believe not in the regulations that would permit such an execution. This is neither retaliation nor is it retribution. I answered my new friend in as few words as possible, just before piercing the spirit, that it was simply his time to go. That's all. I'm linked up. Cavorkian house calls. Every pipe, shell, and mug and bubbler is inhabited by an intoxicated fairy who must be fed regularly with only the finest of herbs, split into rations, so as not to induce jealousy. If treated like a lady and handled with care, she may obey thee with magical air, not exhaled by her hand, but from her wings and from within, sacrificed to the goddess in quality and abundance. And I guarantee you shall knock us off our wallabies with punches. She paints the hollow walls with resinous substance as a reward so small, but layers it with smudges and purified clumps for not ignoring her calls. Certified joke, she hadn't gotten high all morning at all. She was jumpy, tugged a glass slider back as you pulled and sent a crack sliding into a circular curve, shattering reality, revealing her eyes. Imagine the humanity, I'm stealing prize.